Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. Today we will study the module on waste, its types and classification from the paper Solid and Hazardous Waste Management. After going through this module, you will be able to define waste, classify waste and solid waste, and you will be able to differentiate the types of waste and categorize them into different categories. Waste is defined as any unwanted or undesired substances that is thrown away after its primary use. They are generally generated from human and animal activities. Urbanization and increased advancement in industrialization has resulted in the generation of huge amount of waste. Over the years, the waste gets accumulated and causes a lot of impact on the environment and health of an individual. Waste management is generally intended to reduce the effect of waste on the environment and health. Based on this, it is essential that we have to understand, we should have a know-how about what is waste, how it is classified, and how you can segregate into different classifications. Now, let us look into the classification of waste. Based on the physical state of a material, wastes are classified into three types: solid waste, liquid waste, and gaseous waste. Solid waste can be in the form of a solid or semi-solid. Examples: waste tires, scrap material, latex paints and furniture. Liquid wastes are waste which are in the form of a liquid. It is also called as sewage. They are generated from domestic washings, chemicals, oils and other hazardous household liquids. Gaseous wastes are wastes which are generated in the gas form. Examples of them are carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, methane, etc. Now, solid wastes are divided into three types based on their source of generation, based on their types and their physicochemical properties. Based on the source of generation, they are categorized into municipal solid waste, industrial waste, institutional or commercial waste, biomedical waste and agricultural waste. Based on the type, they are categorized as garbage, rubbish, bulk waste, ashes, dead animals, construction and demolition waste and so on. Based on the physicochemical properties, the wastes are categorized into hazardous and non-hazardous, combustible and non-combustible, biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste. Now let us look into the details of each type of waste. Now first let us look into the municipal solid waste. Municipal solid waste are those waste which are commonly referred to as trash or garbage. Examples like street waste, dead animals, abandoned vehicles, household garbage, packing materials and other refuse material which are generated from day-to-day activities. Industrial waste are generally waste generated during industrial activities such as manufacturing and processing involved in chemical plants, paint industry, cement factories, metallurgical plants, thermal power plants, coal gas, sanitary, textile and food processing industries are generally categorized as industrial waste. Solid waste originating from administrative, educational and public buildings such as offices, schools, colleges, hospitals, government centers and other commercial establishments like restaurants, retail shops, markets and warehouses are called as institutional or commercial waste. Agricultural waste include both natural and non-natural waste and they are generated from farming activities. Examples: dairy farming, horticulture, seed growing, livestock breeding, grazing land, market gardens, nursery plots and even woodlands. Some of the examples include spoiled food grains, vegetables, animal and plant waste, litter, pesticides and fertilizers. As the name suggests, wastes produced from hospitals, health centers and other nursing homes are categorized as biomedical waste. It may be a solid or a liquid waste and it includes discarded blood, shafts, soil waste, disposals, anatomical waste, cultures, discarded medicines and other chemical waste. Wastes that include animal and vegetable waste generated from kitchen, cooking, food servings, slaughterhouses and market refuse are called as garbage waste. Examples of garbage waste are vegetable peels, leftover food, skin, bones and meat of slaughtered animals. In general, garbage wastes are biodegradable wastes. Next type of waste is rubbish waste. Solid waste rising as a result of household, commercial and institutional activities excluding garbage and ashes are termed as rubbish. So rubbish is always a mixture of both biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste. Examples are paper, cardboards, carton boxes and torn clothes. Bulk waste are those household waste that consists of household furniture, appliances such as stove, washing machine, refrigerator, mattresses, TV sets, water heaters, tires, lawn mowers, auto parts, trees and brush debris. Ashes are fine powdery residues, cinders and clinkers, and they generally originate from burning of wood, coal, charcoal, coke and other combustible materials. They are generated from houses, institutions and other commercial establishments. Street waste are waste which are generated along the walkways, streets, parks, beaches and vacant plots. They generally comprise of leaves, dirt, dust litter, paper, plastics and other vegetable matter. Animals that die naturally or accidentally are categorized as dead animal waste. They are generally categorized into two types, small animals and large animals. Small animals include cats, dogs, rats, rabbits and poultry. Large animals include horses, cows, goats and sheep. Next, we will discuss about the construction and demolition waste. Waste materials that are generated from the construction, repair and demolition of houses, commercial buildings, roads and other structures are called as construction and demolition waste. They are generated in huge amount. Examples of construction and demolition waste include broken bricks, cement blocks, window panes, doors and other sanitary items. Sewage waste are also called as sludge. They are waste which are generated from wastewater treatment plants. Settled solid components, residuals or semi-solid materials are categorized as sewage waste. They are generally discharged from sewage treatment plants and septic tanks. Plastic waste are generated from various sectors. Some of them include agriculture, construction, consumer goods, household, healthcare, hotel and catering, packaging, telecommunication, air and travel industries. Waste generated from extractive operations of mineral resources are called as mining waste. They include materials such as topsoil, overburden and waste rock that must be removed to gain access to the mineral resources. Radioactive waste are hazardous waste and they are byproducts of nuclear reactions. They decay over time ranging from few days for highly reactive isotopes and to millions of years for a slightly radioactive ones. Examples of radioactive waste include uranium trailings, nuclear fuel waste and nuclear reactive waste. Next type of waste which we'll be seeing is biodegradable or organic waste. Waste that can be decomposed by natural process such as composting, aerobic and other anaerobic process are called as biodegradable waste. They include green waste, food waste, paper waste, biodegradable plastics, sewage sludge, slaughterhouse waste and other waste generated from animals. Non-biodegradable waste are also called as inorganic waste. They are those waste that cannot be decomposed and they remain as such in the environment indefinitely. Some of the examples are plastic waste, fiberglass, metals, rubber tires and other waste. Based on the physicochemical properties, waste are categorized into hazardous and non-hazardous waste. Hazardous waste are defined as chemical materials that can no longer be used for its intended purpose. And they are harmful and potentially harmful to plants, animals, human health and environment. They possess certain properties. Some of them include toxicity, reactivity, ignitability, explosiveness, corrosiveness, infectious and radioactivity. Non-hazardous substances are defined as substances that are safe to commercial, agricultural and other economical activities. Just to summarize whatever we have seen in the entire module, first we started with the definition of waste, then we categorized waste into three types, solid, liquid and gaseous waste, and to end with, we segregated solid waste into different types. Solid waste are classified based on their source of generation. Examples: municipal, agricultural, institutional and commercial waste. And based on their type, they were categorized as garbage, rubbish, ashes, bulky waste. And based on their property, they were categorized as biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste, hazardous and non-hazardous waste. Thank you.